on Primetime News from the newsroom. Shamil Rasuldeen, it's over to you.
Thank you very much, Shalin. Tonight, joining us on the show is Dr. Lakhit Peris, President of the Association of Private Hospitals and Nursing Homes, to talk about COVID-19. Stay connected, stay with News First. We will join you right now. A very good evening to you, Dr. Peris, and thank you very much for joining us this evening. Now, given the current circumstances, Doctor, can someone who has COVID-19 symptoms visit a private hospital registered under the government and obtain medical advice?
Yes, Shamir. Let's say, for example, first of all, I will explain you the process that we follow in a private hospital. One of the key focal areas is triaging to make sure that the patients are safe, the healthcare workers are safe, and the community is safe. So whenever a patient walks in, there is a proper triaging, a screening that is being done. And if the symptoms are extremely similar to COVID, and then what we do is that we isolate them and then send these patients to one of the designated 17 hospitals by the government. So the private hospitals do not treat COVID-19 patients as an inpatient. However, all people who walk into a hospital with temperature or with respiratory symptoms will not be a COVID-19. So hospitals, the clinical staff are extremely competent and they will treat patients in the hospital.
Dr. Peris, does that mean that private hospitals in Sri Lanka do not conduct the PCR test or the COVID-19 test, as you may call it?
Yeah, it's like this. The government has, in a circular recently, has allowed the private sector to conduct COVID-19 PCR tests. However, not as an outpatient screening test, but as a test carried out for an admitted patient. But at the same time, the private hospitals are not supposed to admit COVID-19 patients. And so therefore, where we would carry out a COVID PCR test is in a situation where if there is a highly suspicious patient in one of our wards, then we would carry out a PCR test to see if it's COVID-19, and then the patient would be transferred.
So Dr. Peris, let's say I am scared that I have COVID-19, hence I go to a private hospital, get myself admitted, and can I request the private hospital authorities to conduct a PCR test on me and make sure that I'm free of COVID-19? Is there a possibility?
Unfortunately, that possibility is not there, Shamir, because of the fact that the private hospitals will go through a very stringent triaging process, and if patient shows symptoms of COVID, what we need to do is we need to support the government. We need to support the government regulations. They have a beautiful mechanism in place. So what we do is that we triage the patient. If we identify the patient as having COVID suspect patient, we would be transferring that patient to one of the designated hospitals.
So in other words, you're saying that the private hospitals in Sri Lanka at present discourage people from coming to private hospitals to obtain medication if they are suspected of COVID-19?
I wouldn't say that we would discourage, but at the same time, the procedure and the protocol that we need to follow is that all COVID-19 suspected patients should be directed to one of those designated government hospitals.
Dr. Peris, let's say if I have had close contact with a COVID-19 patient, or maybe I was living in the same building or even close proximity to the house where the infected person was found, what should I do?
I think the first thing is that we as citizens of Sri Lanka should support the government in being truthful. We see that in most of the other countries, people are flocking around hospitals, but unfortunately hospitals don't have the capacity to treat these patients. And this is why the mortality rate, even in some of the Western world, is very high. So to answer your question, the first thing is that be truthful. If you have had direct or indirect contact, you need to make sure that you are truthful. Get advice. You don't need to walk into a hospital to get advice. There are lots of numbers that are being given to people. Call one of these numbers and then they will instruct you what to do. So it's very, very important that you be truthful. You have a social responsibility towards the nation. So self-quarantine, making sure that you have social distancing, good habits like washing hands. So these are some of the basic things that we need to follow.
Dr. Peters, I think you hit the nail on the head saying about being truthful, because the mortality rate from COVID-19 stands at less than 4% at present the world over. And Sri Lanka, the number stands at less than 2% at the moment. And 95% of the people who have been infected with COVID-19 can recover, and only 20% out of which will go into severe conditions or severe respiratory problems. So hence being truthful is very important, isn't it, doctor?
Very, very important. And if we are to win the game against COVID-19, and I think Sri Lanka has a very robust mechanism to fight COVID-19, I think the people need to support this.
Dr. Peters, sanitization for all is something that reminds us now when it comes to COVID-19. How important is this factor, and what must governments do to make sure that sanitation for all is imposed and practiced right throughout Sri Lanka?
I think we're going to have a new normal once we get through the COVID-19 issue. One thing is that there is a lot of awareness that is being created both by the corporate sector and as well as the government sector about the importance of especially the hand sanitization. How to wash hands. I mean, we never, probably until this really hit Sri Lanka, people did not know how to wash their hands. Washing hands was thought of as a very simple thing, but there are steps that you need to follow. People do know about that, right? And so I think there will be a new normal where people will want to will be more concerned about self-hygiene. In the past, we never considered touching our face to be wrong, but now people do know that they should not be touching their face. If they want to touch their face, they need to wash hands before that. But it's much easier to be without touching your face. So I think these are some of the things that we have done a great job, both by the private sector as well as the public sector, to educate people.
Dr. Peters, conducting tests are very important when it comes to combating this problem as a whole. In particular, you see countries like Italy, countries like China, conducting rapid tests, and even in the US, you see a 15-minute test being introduced to fight COVID-19 and to make sure that they get a proper count in terms of the numbers who are infected with COVID-19. So let's say, can I be tested for COVID-19 if I am not sick? Is there a possibility? Let's say I go to hospital and I say, I am scared, so can I be subjected to a PCR test? Is there a possibility?
No, as of now, there is no possibility for that. And also, I think the public should understand that COVID-19 PCR is not a screening test. It is to confirm whether you're COVID. So I don't believe that a person who suspects that I would be having COVID should be doing a COVID-19 test. But to confirm what you said just now about some of the countries, in very early stage of COVID, really ramped up testing facilities. And through that, they were able to bring down the curve. So we also believe that aggressive testing is something that we need to consider. But having said that, if you look at today, if you look at Singapore, there are more than 60 cases on a single day. Now, Singapore was one country that started rapid testing. They really ramped up PCR testing at a very early stage. They have extremely good contact tracing contact tracing mechanisms, but yet Sri Lanka is much, much better with God's grace.
Dr. Pieris, the general notion amongst the public is the fact that private hospitals and nursing homes are money-minded. They're always looking at making money. And when you look at some of the hospitals in Colombo, private hospitals in Colombo and urban areas, all of them are directed towards making money. In a situation of this sort, where Sri Lanka is facing a pandemic and a very dire situation in terms of its healthcare system, how do you see the role of the private hospitals and nursing homes pitching in and contributing to make sure that we are all okay?
Yeah. So to answer your first, I wouldn't say an accusation, but probably that's
a
perception.
Notion, yes.
That's a perception. I don't think that private hospitals do operate focusing only on the profitability factor. One need to understand that running a private hospital, the operating costs are extremely high. Our return on investment is very low. The reason is that we need to have a very robust clinical governance structure, from international best practices to accreditations. The equipment are extremely expensive, and sometimes the equipment goes obsolete even before the payback period. So that's another different subject. So I don't believe that the private sector is there to make profits. And if you really look at the financials of the hospitals, and none of the hospitals make more than
How can private hospitals help the government's fight to eradicate this pandemic?
Yeah. So even now we do that. Number one is that we are open 24/7. All our facilities are operating, from OPDs to inpatient facilities to ETUs. And this is a very, very difficult time for the private sector hospitals as well, because our occupancies are extremely low. Our operating cost is very high. And with the COVID-19, even the operating costs have become more high because of the very high consumption of personal protective equipment. And these are because of the high demand in Sri Lanka and globally, these purchase prices are very high. So despite all the issues that the private sector is facing as of now, because of this situation, I think we are doing a great job in making sure that we provide our services 24/7. Our staff is so committed and motivated. Hospitals have taken the initiative to make sure that they follow world-class protocols, guidelines by the government. And I think this is an example of two sectors, from the public and the private sector, working towards one single objective.
Thank you very much, Dr. Lakhit Pieris, President of the Association of Private Hospitals and Nursing Homes. For full disclosure, Dr. Lakhit Pieris is a holder of a PhD and not an MBBS degree. We leave you tonight with a quote, as I always do. It is health that is the real wealth, and not pieces of gold and silver. It's back to the newsroom.
Thank you very much, Shamil Rasuldeen.